Who's Lynn? Lynn Braddock.
She left.
You know where she went?
I don't know.
Lynn, is your man really take you to America?
Yes, of course.
What about all this?
I can't take everything. Take anything you want. Goodbye, Min. Take care.
Bye.
What I've got.
Remain, and I wonder, will it find me? What's the need?
I should run for Brad.
Well, I would. I didn't think you needed it.
Oh, really?
Mr. Braddock?
That's right.
Colonel James Braddock?
What can I do for you?
Could I have a few moments of your time?
Sit down.
Thank you. Please, could we please talk more privately?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
Would you like something to drink?
No, thank you. I'm Reverend Polanski from the American Children's Mission in Vietnam. Occasionally I come to this country to raise funds for the mission. I was hoping I could find you before I went back.
Find me? Why?
About a year ago, a young American child came to the mission begging for help. He told me that his mother was sick. I went to see if there's anything I could do and found out you worked for the U.S. Embassy during the war. She has been severely punished by the Vietnamese government. Having a half-American son has made things even worse for her.
I'm sorry to hear that, but what's that got to do with me?
The woman's married name is Mrs. James Braddock.
What did you say?
I'm talking about your wife, Mr. Braddock. Lin Tang Kang.
You're mistaken.
There is no mistake.
My wife died during the fall of Saigon.
Your wife is alive. I know her quite well. Your son's name is Van. He's now 12 years old.
My wife and I didn't have a son.
Why is it so hard for you to believe me?
Because I saw my wife's body burned to a crisp, that's why.
You may have seen a body, but it wasn't your wife. Lin Tang Kang is alive.
Believe whatever you want, Reverend. A few moments are out.
Even if you did believe me, I doubt if there's anything you could do. I've already gone to the State Department and they will do nothing. But I had to let you know. Goodbye, Mr. Braddock. God be with you.
Thank you.
Braddock. CIA. Please come with us.
Wait outside. It's been a long time, Colonel Braddock. How have you been?
You know how I've been, Little John. Now, what do you want?
You just met with a Reverend Polanski.
So?
Did he tell you some kind of crazy story about your wife being alive?
Is it a crazy story?
Of course it is.
mistake, little John. I didn't believe it until now. What are you going to do about getting them out?
Nothing.
If I don't get them out, they're going to die.
People die every day. Braddock, I'm warning you, don't step on any toes.
I don't step on toes, little John. I step on necks.
Take me downtown.
Try knocking me off?
How the hell are you, Braddock?
Did you get everything?
Yes, I got everything. But it sure as hell wasn't easy.
That's why I appreciate it, Nick.
That's what friends are for, Braddock. Which reminds me, got the money? Hurry. Plane won't be loaded for several hours yet. We got a long drive out of town. Oh, shit. Here comes trouble.
Go get the car and pull out front.
Okay.
Hey. You're not going anywhere, Mikulchek. Take him to the car.
Jeez. Hey, where's the little bit? Hey, watch my beer, man. Hey,
I warned you, Braddock, not to fuck with us. Don't try to stop me, little John. You're stopped.
Come on. Breathe, asshole, you're dead!
Excuse me, girls.
Braddock! Cut him off! Cut him off! Braddock! Braddock!
Stop right there.
done. You actually made it. After us.
How far is it to the plane?
It's quite a ways out of Bangkok. No, it'll be daylight before we get there.
Sure this thing will get off the ground?
Oh, relax, Mother. Sit back. Enjoy the ride. We just like Coney Island.
Bay.
We're gonna have to skim the waves. When we get there, it's down underneath their radar. Hey, Braddock, you don't supply. Why don't you take the controls, eh? Give me a rest. Let's see if you could lie as well as you can drive, eh?
It's been a long time.
Well, you can do it. I tell you. It's a lot calmer up here than it is in your automobile. You know, when we get to the drop zone, I'm going to pull her up into a climb and you'll have about 5 seconds to make the drop before I put her into a drive.
I'll need 10 seconds.
Well, if you're a good boy, I'll give you 10 seconds. I'd be coming back. I guess we never really can leave, can we? Ah, come on, get your ass back there. I'll take it.
Braddock, mother.
Let us each give thanks in our own way.
Sim Chu Bang Fu Plang Cho Chung Kong.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, wise and good, for home and friends and daily food. Bless, dear Lord, the food we take, and keep us all. Keep us all home and safe. Amen.
Amen.
Please start without me. I'll be right there. Braddock, how on earth did you get here?
Where's my wife?
She doesn't live very far.
Can you tell me how to get there?
I'll take you there. Here, wear this. There is a curfew. We must be very careful. I tried to tell you how bad it was.
You'd better go, Reverend. And thanks.
Good luck. God bless you.
Sure.
It's not important. I prayed you would come for us, and you are here. That is all that matters to Vaughn and I. This is your son, Jim.
Hello, Van. Vaughn, on your way?
I speak English, brother.
He dreamed about you. Sometimes, in very difficult moments, I would find him talking to you as if you were there. And somehow you would make things right for him. But one day, he stopped believing. I tried to keep you alive in his heart. I tried.
I guess I know how you feel, Van. Thinking that I deserted you and your mother, but I want you to know that...
Van, please.
If I'd known that you and your mother were alive, there's nothing in the world that would have stopped me from coming for you before now.
I have changed, Jim. I'm sorry I'm no longer pretty for you.
You'll always be beautiful to me. We have to go now.
Demalticon. Let me check the street first.
Man, hurry.
Ivan, Dominic, come man.
Come back, Mer, you don't mind.
Mày làm cái gì đó? Bố mày còn biết chuyện gì mà sao? Đuổi!
Tôi muốn đi về nhà.
Tại sao mày đi đâu rồi này? Trả lời ngay, muốn vào thọ con.
Dạ, không. Tôi muốn đi về nhà.
Mặc sàn từ bộ đôi, khó năng. Đi theo tao.
Mày ra!
Chuyện gì vậy?
It might be a tight squeeze, but I think you're going to enjoy the ride, Ben.
If you say so, Braddock.
Please be patient. We've only had each other for 12 years. And now... it is very difficult for him. He will need some time.
We have all the time in the world.
I love you very much, Jim Braddock. I think I should talk to her son for a moment.
I'll go get the boat ready.
Everything will be all right.
You don't care about me now. You only care about him.
It is not true. It was our love that brought you into this world. Your father loves you as I do. If you will only give him a chance. Please drive on.
I'm very scared.
I know you are. But once we get to America, everything will be better. I promise. Your father promises.
Lynn, we have to get out of here. Hurry!
Your lamb. Very foolish to come back. I am General Quok. How do you do, Madame Braddock? Banyoi. And this must be your son, Lang. Very good looking boy. When I received the report that a strange-looking boat had outrun my gunboats and heading towards Ho Chi Minh City, I took the privilege of assuming it was you, Colonel Braddock, since Reverend Polanski had just returned from your country. But now... Braddock, You must pay for the crimes that you have committed against my beloved country.
They have nothing to do with this.
You are absolutely right.
You will find your first test quite challenging. Usually we use people who are a little bit taller. Tested many before, Braddock, and no one has lasted even an hour. Maybe you can be the first, eh?
I'll do whatever you want. Just let the boy go.
You will do what I want, anyways. Well done. Well done, brother. You are every bit as tough as your reputation. I like that. I like that. Disappointed me, Braddock.
Do not! Roland! Can you make it? Go to the mission.
What are you doing?
Where is Braddock? Where is Braddock?
I don't know where Braddock is, General.
You lie, priest. You lie. We know you helped Braddock.
You must be mistaken.
You're there. You lie. Perhaps a change of environment will help you to think more clearly.
Mookie, I.
Go down, go.
Mookie, I. Mookie, I. Take him back, Dolly. Mountain.
Please, no. I can't leave my children. They need me.
Of course. I would not want to separate you from your half-breed American bastard children. Take them all! Take them all! Mountain! Mountain! Back in! Bring them! Mountain! Mountain!
Thank you.
Baron! Them two in our tree! Go down ya!
Priest! The new home will be going to have prison! Baron!
Let's go.
中挂 Braddock
Okay.
Kilometers to the border.
You don't expect these children to walk 90 kilometers?
I don't expect a damn thing, Reverend. But walk or crawl, we're gonna make it. Come on, kids.
Dead tired. We must stop to rest. Please, Braddock. You're not very strong.
Wait here. Thank you.
the kids. Hurry.
Come, come, children. Quiet. Be quiet.
Children! Braddock! Dinva! Dinva! Oh my God.
Get back there with the kids, Reverend. It's gonna get rough.
It's going to get tough.
James Braddock, calling American Military Assistance Command. Come in. Mayday, mayday. Take a seat. Mayday, mayday. This is Colonel Braddock.
I'm at a crippled C-47. I have a plane load of Amerasian children. Losing fuel. I'm approximately 80 miles east of the Thai border.
If anyone can hear me, please transfer this message to the American Military Assistance Command. Is everyone okay back there? Are you okay?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm fine too.
Look, there's the border.
As soon as I take the guards out, you get the kids over the bridge as fast as you can. Do you hear what I said?
on my way over here. I was wondering what you would be like. I want you to know you're everything I wanted in a son. And I'm very proud of you. I love you.
Happening, Dan?
Braddock and the children. We intercepted a radio message. They crashed somewhere near here.
Leave him, Dan. I gotta help him.
Leave it alone, General. He's on his own. No one crosses the border.
Finish, Braddock! I've won!
Harrah! Harrah!
They will not dare to cross. What's he doing? Hold your position!
He makes one wrong move, we'll climb up his ass.
You got it. The Americans are bluffing. They will not dare do any more.
I can see the love of freedom shining in your eyes. I can see the love of freedom in your eyes. Oh, when I look into your eyes.